What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? Thank you so much for tuning in to today's video. My name is Mike Dyke. I'm a licensed master plumber in the entire state of South Carolina and also in some jurisdictions of the great state of New York. And sitting beside me is Peter Piper, Peter the Sponge, whatever you want to call him. Just make sure you don't call him late for work like he was this morning. Oh, he overslept partying last night with some Latina chicas.
No, but sure.
Yeah. Okay. This morning we are heading into Long Beach. We're going to take the Atlantic Beach Bridge. We're going to head over to the great city of Long Beach on the Barrier Island off of the south shore of Nassau County. And I'm about to get sodomized by the toll man. You ready?
There you go.
Thank you very much.
How's it going?
Wow. I gave him 10. I got back 2. $8. $8 to cross this miserable bridge. And you think I'm bullshitting? There it is. The toll collector. The Nassau County Bridge Authority, by the way, the biggest racket. They only have one bridge in there under their authority. And the only reason why they collect tolls is so those guys can have jobs. But they're going to Easy Pass now, so I guess whatever. $8 for my little Metris cargo van. $8. That talk about being ripped off. There's a reason why New York State is not a good state for the growth and cultivation of business. Yeah. And that is why every little thing they tax you hard on, like a bridge, less than 4 months ago, to cross that bridge was $2.
That's pathetic.
$2. Now it's $8. And you know what their excuse is? Well, people wanted Easy Pass. Like, shut the front door. Don't talk to me like I'm stupid. Anyway, we're heading to a service call in Long Beach. We have an existing client whose central air conditioning system is not working. So let's go see what's going on, and hopefully we can get some great content. Smash that thumbs up in advance, and please take a moment to subscribe to the Mikey Pipes Philanthropy YouTube channel. Appreciate it in advance. Hello again. I remember to always come to the side door, so.
I was wondering if you were going to remember.
Of course. Well, so that has been since last year we've been here, right?
Yeah.
That's a good thing.
Yeah. How you doing?
But now it's broken?
Well,
what's going?
So the thermostat is blank.
Thermostat is blank.
So I checked the box downstairs.
Okay.
I couldn't find anything tripped.
Okay.
The batteries, I put in a fresh set of batteries.
Okay. Okay, Peter, grab a tool bag and we'll see what's going on.
All right, Peter, let's take a look at the thermostat. And here it is. This White Rogers thermostat. He said he changed the batteries in it. So one of the first things we're going to do is rip it off the wall.
I tested the batteries. You know, I didn't want to pull it off the wall.
So there's Y. Is there a light here?
That's the base. Yeah.
There's Y, there's G, and there's RC. So let's get the voltmeter out real fast, and let's test power between RC and G and RC and Y, make sure we have voltage.
Nice. Okay, so let's do RC and G.
And we have, only 15 volts, interesting. Let's go to Y.
Mm-hmm.
28 volts. So you have 28 volts, I want to say. Let's put it back there to G, just right there. And no, still got 15, but nonetheless, let's take our little flat screwdriver and let's take out that screw terminal for R, C, and let's go to G. Let's see if we can get the fan to run. No, you were right. Okay, let's take that wire out. Just to wiggle it. I want to see you wiggle it. You should be able to get that out already.
Yeah.
It's just stuck on the way of the terminal is there, okay? Be careful. You want to lick that?
No.
You sure?
$100.
You'll do it for $100?
No.
Will you?
No, it's fine.
$100 if you lick that? Yeah? Listen, you can touch it. So what difference does that make?
True. All
right?
Yeah.
Okay. Take out G, which is fan. Okay. And now let's touch R and G together.
Mm-hmm.
You just gotta loosen it up. Okay, touch them together. Wait for it. There it is. So you have fan. Good. We have a dead thermostat.
Right, so it turns out that our anchors, plastic anchors, are perfect. So let's take this. Let's take our
white Emerson or whatever it is.
White Rogers Emerson, yeah. It's a great thermostat. Now, see how it's a little bit off of there? Bang that in. Bang these both in a little bit better. Not with that. We have a thing. Look, give me that. Give me that.
So make it more flush. Just don't go too much. And when you're doing that, make sure there's nothing on the opposite wall, like a picture frame, that's going to fall down while you're banging.
They make hammers.
I like that too. The hammer's not in the tool bag. All right, so here's your plate. All right, so now it's more flush. All right, and put those screws in there. You got to love how Emerson includes a little built-in little level there, which it never works. No, it doesn't work. It's too small, so you can't be that precise. You know, you could think it's level, but it's not.
You get claims taken care of when there's a claim is a yep. problem.
So if you noticed, we're going to pull tug on each one, make sure that they're all on, RC, Y, and G. And do we take our level? Let's take the level. Let's see if it's level.
What if the floor's not level? Then is he going to look at this and think it's not level? Or if the ceiling is...
Well, the level doesn't lie. The right. bubble of air in water doesn't lie.
This is true. But it might look off in the context of where you have it.
Sure. Correct. All right, so now we're going to set the time and day. And then we'll cycle the thermostat on and make sure the AC works.
There's a thermostat. Into the place.
Fanta on. A little backlit right there. And there's the fan. And let's poop off to cool. And let's lower this to 60. And we'll see if we hear the compressor turn on. There's the click of that. We can go check though.
Okay, we're walking up to the condenser. As you can probably hear, our compressor's running. Obviously, fan's running. And pretty cool air coming out. So we're gonna let it run. Make sure everything's working properly. And we should be good to go. Just a bad thermostat.
All right, so it's fairly easy to use. The top left-hand corner not only gives us the time, but it gives us the battery strength indicator. That's full.
Right.
All right. The time, and it's already set for Monday. This large display right here is the current indoor temperature, which is 65. Keep in mind, it was in the truck for a little while, so it may or may not be accurate. Biggest thing to know, since it's a cooling-only thermostat, is you have a switch here. And forget about what my finger's covering, which says heat. We have off and we have cool. Mm-hmm. If we want the cooling on, just lift the lever from off to cool. Fan, I just turned it to on because I want to hear the blower come on. We're going to put it back to auto. Generally, you know, this setting is set to auto. If you have the windows open and it's a nice breezy day out and you want just some circulation inside the house, you can put the fan switch to on and the air handler fan will come on and you'll circulate air. You know, with some, you know, force. So you'll suck in air from the, you know, from the windows and out the diffusers. Another thing to keep in mind, I don't know if your old one had it. Was your old one programmable?
Yeah, but I never really...
Okay. So one of the best things to keep in mind, let's say we want to set it for, let's say, 60. We want to hold it there. You're going to see the word hold displayed right there. Mm-hmm. It will stay there indefinitely, hold, unless you hit run and you're going to run the program. Was the outdoor unit running?
Yep.
Okay, good. So now the internal program of the thermostat that comes factory default, you know, during the day, it's 85 degrees. So to avoid a nuisance callback, we are going to program the thermostat, which is some lower temperatures. So we're going to hit menu, and we're going to go to schedule, and we're going to hit next. And at 6 o'clock in the morning, we're going to hit next again.
So this is a touch.
Yes. Just like that. We're going to set, what temperature do you normally like to keep it at the thermostat set to for the air conditioning? Give me a random.
Say 70.
Okay, so I'm just going to set them all for 72, right?
Okay.
Just because, you know, in case it ever diverts back to that, at least it'll put it back to 72. So I'm changing all them to 72. and 5 o'clock, 72. And then there's a 10 o'clock overnight. Oh. And it's not going to, you're never going to use it, but in case someone decides to press rent, run, you're going to have that there. Saturday and Sunday is already default to 72. So all I'm going to do is hit exit, and I'm going to run the program. And let's say I want to hold it at 70 indefinitely. I'm going to press hold. Hold's going to be displayed there. Whatever I set this to, it's not going to deviate unless the batteries die or unless someone touches run. Went back to 72.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to hold it 70. But for now, off and auto. Easy peasy?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
See? Nice service call, replace the thermostat, but most importantly, they have a second home in Florida.
Yeah.
And it happens to be in Boynton Beach, exactly where my in-laws live. And in exactly the same area where I'm going to set up Pipe Doctor Home Services of Florida. And as I left, he goes, let me know when you're down there. I'm like, you got it. And this is a customer we've been going out to for years. I'm looking at the history. There's almost a dozen service records for this customer. And that's how you develop relationships and strengthen the existing ones. All right, ladies and gentlemen, hope you enjoyed this video. Thermostat blank, bad thermostat. Peter got that under control. He's just a few steps away from being in a truck by himself.
Yep.
And he's nervous, I think he's nervous.
Okay.
He's gonna fail miserably, but he's gonna learn every step along the way. Smash that thumbs up button. Make sure you check out the Mikey Pipes Philanthropy YouTube channel. And if you wouldn't mind donating to the organization where we provide free and or low cost plumbing, heating, and air conditioning services to people in the community who can't afford it. And just the other week, Peter and I, was it a week ago today?
I think it was the prior week before.
Week before that. 2 weeks ago today, Peter and I were in Vandergrift, Pennsylvania, which is about an hour outside of Pittsburgh, and we installed essentially a $25,000 system for this family who had a tragic loss. They lost their mother, the husband, a tragic fatal fall. The 42-year-old son has autism, and the lone breadwinner of the home, underpaid guy, really nice guy, and we put in a brand new system with the help of from Bosch Thermal Technology, and also the great guys, Justin and Craig, over Precision Heating and Cooling Services. They're based in Plum, Pennsylvania. Check it out, the Mikey Pipes Philanthropy YouTube channel. I got a bunch of videos on there, and all proceeds go to the cause.